I think these kids need help.
What they need is a bath.
You're passing judgment on people you know nothing about.
Maybe that's why your church is so empty.
When God walks in here, brings me a hippie, I'll ask him what it's all about, because I do not understand.
This house has a very good vibe.
Let's start off, and I want to talk about the importance of going to see a movie at the theater, right? Like, the world has changed so much. There's so much content available, streaming and whatnot, but to get to, like, bring all your friends and go get excited, what does that mean, especially for a film like Jesus Revolution?
I think there's certain films that are just incredible to experience with an audience. And Jesus Revolution is one of those films. It was so good to see it with a crowd. It's my favorite movie to watch with a crowd, with an audience of people, and to hear them laugh and cry and cheer during the movie. I've never had that experience before. And as a community, what people don't realize is when we unify our voice together and launch something, it creates culturally something called FOMO, which is the fear of missing out. So when we join our voices together in a moment in time, a theatrical movie is a lot like an election. Your movie ticket really is your vote. And it signals to the industry, these are the type of movies that we want. When the studio system sees success, they do more of that. So it's important on that level. But it signals to the culture, which I think is even more important with this film, there's something going on here. And when we make a lot of noise, millions and millions of people end up experiencing the story that would not otherwise experience. That's the importance of opening weekend. That's the importance of going to the theater and seeing it. Let's make noise together. Mm. With this movie specifically, to say let's have a great night in a theater, and I think you'll really enjoy the film. But when we do that, we're saying to everyone, we want this to happen again. We want a movement of love to sweep the country like it did in 1970. So that's why it's so important to go see it in theaters, to go see it opening weekend, and to celebrate it in that way. And I think the movie won't let you down. I think it's just a wonderful experience with a crowd of people.
There's a lot of people that are lost. They're sheep without a shepherd. But that, how can you even seek truth or grow if you're rejected by others? So maybe unpack that theme a little bit for us with this film and kind of how it can mimic some of the things going on today.
Our media purposefully teaches us that there's an other to hate. And we're so taught to be tribal and look at these people that aren't in your little bubble as an enemy. That's not what Jesus was about. Jesus went out of his way to be outside of his bubble, outside of the tribe, outside of his synagogues, you know, and that's where his ministry was. He was out with the people. And he was criticized for it and scorned by the moralists, by the religious community. Like, look who he hangs out with, man. Who is this guy? He's a freak, you know. And so for a brief moment of time in our movie, you have this square, really neurotic, you know, conservative pastor that's like, okay, I'm going to let these crazy people into my church, you know, and then they bring the peace and the love and the unity. And when he opened up his heart for this thing to happen, I mean, there's just this explosive moment in time that, like, changed the course of, you know, modern Christianity in the West. Yeah, man, I want this movie to be a callback to that. We are indoctrinated culturally by our media, especially, to hate and to pick a side and a tribe. But if we all sat down together and had meaningful conversation and got out of this cancel culture and this, you know, this political idolatry, honestly, that we have going on right now, but if we got out of that and just went out of our way to love each other, because, man, when I see the gauntlet that Jesus threw down to us and how we are to live, he said, love your enemies. I've met like 4 people in my life that are able to do that, but I mean, that's the practice, you know? And so, I don't know, man. I saw Chuck loving a perceived enemy in this movie, and it broke all the walls down, and I really feel like that's what we need in our culture, and I appreciate that question a lot.
Joel Greig's character says, you know, that he's not seeking fame, but that he really wants his name to mean something. And I feel like that, for everybody, it could have this sense of, like, I want to know that my life has purpose. Maybe talk to me a little bit about that.
I mean, look, Greg, you know, the real Greg Laurie, I mean, he grew up in a very dysfunctional and broken home. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, I think you have that when you see statistics show, when you see homes that are fatherless homes that those children really have a lot higher wall and barrier to overcome. And so all the more reason why you need to have a movie like Jesus Revolution and the themes of love and unity, why those are so front and center in this story and so much needed for today's culture and where we're at as a society.
Talk to me about, you know, we see that within Joel's character playing Greg, but then we also see that with Anna Grace and Kathy, you know, being misunderstood. Clearly she loves her parents, but so this idea of kind of bridging that gap, and then of course with Kelsey Grammer, Chuck Smith, and his daughter, right? So talk about the familiar kind of clashing, but that's in the end what makes everything so successful.
You know, I think that you just pour whatever you're going through in life onto a screen as a filmmaker. We're entertainers, and I think they call it the rage of the inarticulate. You know, so you just sort of wrestle with things on screen. It's its own form of therapy, I guess. And so, you know, my daughter's 14, you know, and you know, and so you know, you just want desperately to connect with them and to bridge a gap and to have a relationship and so it's so good to see the movie with, you know, my wife and my daughter. We watched it last night together. And Kate's like crying. She's like, this movie's so emotional. I have to redo all my makeup, you know, and she loves Joel, you know, but we really try to make movies that are intentionally multi-generational and try to use a screen as something that pulls people together instead of pulls people apart. And that's very intentional. And so I love this story for that purpose. And I just really believe in her generation and their same sort of spiritual awareness that a generation in the 60s had, that sort of spiritual awakening, that, I mean, there has to be more to life. I have to have a purpose. I have to matter in some way. There has to be some form of truth, you know? And I think that's all happening again. And I think it's happening in a generation. And so a part of the reason we told this story is to say to my daughter and to everyone like her, like, this can happen again in your time. And it rescued us once before, it can rescue us again. And it's your turn, and I'm very passionate about that theme, and I think the movie is a way for generations to connect, and for a generation that lived the story, to, you know, my parents were there last night. They lived the Jesus movement. Mm-hmm. They were their lives were changed in that movement, and so I think that it's an opportunity for one generation to connect with another, and we love making films like that.